spanning tail garden. That is a transparent bridge. So the second type, it is a source routing bridge. In the transparent bridge, a main bottleneck or complexity, all the routing issues will be handled by the bridges. So that is the main issue. So automatically, you know, the complexity at the bridge, because always, you know, we are going to find the road bridge, then we are going to find the designated bridge and port, all these things. So that is the main problem. So if number of the nodes are high, number of LANs are high, then it is very tough to handle all the routing issues by the bridge. So the second one, it is the source routing bridge. In this bridge, so most of the routing table issues will be taken care by the source node, not by the bridge. So this class we will see about the source routing bridge. Then this is the last topic in the module. So the source routing bridge, it is developed by IEEE 802.5. This is, you know, it uses token ring network to interconnect the various the nodes, to extend the nodes. The main thing I told, you know, unlike transparent bridge, all the implementation complexity will be on the end station. In the previous case, it is on the burden is on the bridge. Here, you know, all these things are, it is on the end station. So each source station determines the route to destination. Each station will determine source to, that is the route from source to the destination. So the basic principle begin SRB. Each station determines the route to the destinations when it wants to send a frame. Before sending the frame, first, you know, it find the route to each destination. Then it will start to send the respective frames. So automatically, you know, because here the bridge is not involved to finding the route, only source is involved. So the route informations will be added in the header of the frame, from which route, from, you know, from source distance route, which bridge, which LAN it is reaching end users. All those routing informations will be included in the header of the frame. So routing informations, you know, here in it is having the routing control. Then the designator from where to where it is going. So this routing control, if you see here, it contains the frame type. What is the frame we are going to, type of frame we are going to use. So this is a different frame type we will see in the next part, different frame types. It is having the U frame, I frame, S frame, all these things we will see in the forthcoming modules. Then length of the routing information field. What is the length of this routing information? That also included in the routing control. The direction of the route given by the route designator, which direction it is going. So this route designated field, it contains the LAN number and the bridge number. We will see with an example for easy understanding. So in general, when stations want to send a frame to another stations on a different LAN, then stations uses routing table. If the route, that is if the route to the destination is found, that station inserts the routing information. Already, you know, if the route is known to the respective the source, then it inserts the respective routing information in the frame. Otherwise, it will perform the route discovery procedure to find the route. First, you know, if already, so suppose the first time it is sending, definitely there won't be any routing information will be available. That time it uses, you know, route discovery procedure to establish the connection. Once, you know, if it is sending second times the frame to the same destination, automatically routing information will be available. Automatically, you know, that routing information will insert into the frame, no need for going for the route discovery. If it is first time it is going for the transmissions, automatically, definitely it should go for the route discovery, the procedure from source to destination. So to discover the route to destinations, each station broadcast single route broadcast. First, you know, each station will send a single route broadcast frame to identify the route. So the frame visits every LAN once and eventually reaches destination. Now, once destination reaches, the destination sends all the route broadcast frame, which generates all routes. For example, if you see this example, we see this diagram. So let us consider host X. It is at the respective the source. This is destination. So during the initial stage, first it send the single route broadcast frame. Now X is sending the single route cast frame through LAN. Now this LAN one will send in all the directions. It will send in this direction. It will send in this direction. Now host X sends the explorer frame. Each bridge receiving the frame, that is both bridge 1 and bridge 2 in this example, copies the frame into all outbound. So each and every bridge it checks. It copies the information from the inbound. It checks all the outbound, all the outbound. If it is more than the one outbound is there, that is outbound is there, it will broadcast, it will send to the all the directions. For example, suppose we are having one more LAN here. So this is LAN 5. Let us consider this is a small example. So now what all things it is coming into this bridge 2 frame, it will broadcast to all the outbound ports, Here, during these things, so bridge will add the ID of the input, that is, you know, input ID of the LAN. Then it adds the respective bridge ID. Then it will add an ID of the output LAN. So during receiving of each and every bridge, so in the routing information frame, the bridge will add incoming LAN ID, bridge ID, then outgoing LAN ID. So all these things will be added here. Then it will pass. Similarly, bridge 1 will add incoming LAN ID is LAN 1. So bridge 1, outgoing is LAN 3. Again, if it is reaches this bridge 3, again bridge 3 will append additionally. Then it will transmit to the respective host. So when host X is explore frames reach host Y, host Y replies to each individually using the accumulated routing information. Once you know it receiving all the frames in different route. So now host Y will transmit response to all the frames, by removing all the routing information identities. Because while receiving here, it will contains LAN 1, bridge 1, LAN 3, bridge 3, LAN 2, all the information will be available. It remove all these things. Again, you know, it responds to the broadcast frame throughout the, all the informations to, again, to reach just the host X. So upon receipt of all the response frames, host X chooses a path based on some predetermined criteria. So this criteria will be, we will see with an example. What is the predetermined criteria? We will see with an example. Once all these things will be over, now the host X will have a respective the route, two routes. One is nothing but in this route, one other is in this route. For example, from LAN 1 to bridge 1, bridge 1 to LAN 3, LAN 3 to bridge 3, bridge 3 to LAN 2, that is the host. Another route, this is the route 1. Another route from LAN 1 to bridge 2, LAN 4, bridge 4, LAN 2. This is the second route. So in this way, it automatically, the source will update the routing informations on the frame, So we will see with an example, this example. Consider a bridge LAN shown below. Assume that B1, B3, B4, B6 are part of the spanning tree. That means B2, B5, it contains a block post. The meaning is here. B2, B5, it contains the block port. That means it is a redundant bridge. So suppose S1 wants to send a frame to S3, but has not learned the route. So S1 does not know the route through which bridge, which LAN it should suppose to send the frame to S3. Sketch the routes followed by the single route and all route broadcast frames using the route discovery procedure. So this is the diagram. So from these things, B1, B3, B4, B6, B1, B3, B4, B6 are, it is on a respective the spanning tree. That means B2, B5, B7, it contains the block codes, because since it is a redundant bridge, because from LAN1 to LAN3 you can go B1 LAN2 B3 also, so B2 is considered as a redundant bridge. Similarly, B5 also considers redundant bridge, B7 is also redundant bridge. From this problem, B1, B3, B4, B7 are part of the spanning tree. That means, so B2, B5, B7, it is all the block codes. It is not virtually connected. Physically, it is present, but virtually, it is not connected. So this is the given problem. So now we are going to find the all root discovery. So the single root discovery, it always starts from a source to destination. That is S1 to S3 it will go. We see here the single root broadcast frame, it will go from source to destination. So it is because B2, B5, B7, it is in block ports. Now, so S1 sent and respective the single root discovery, the broadcast frame to B1, because B2 is a block port. It is going to B1, it is going to LAN2. From LAN2, it contains both two paths. One is B4, one is B3. So now, from LAN2, it's sending the single root broadcast frame to B3, LAN3, B6, LAN5. In another way, it sends from LAN2, B4, LAN5. So this is nothing but the single root broadcast frame. During each and everything, I told you, so the bridge will record the incoming LAN ID, bridge ID, outgoing LAN ID. So for B1, incoming LAN ID is LAN1, outgoing LAN ID is LAN2. So similarly for B3, incoming LAN ID is LAN2, outgoing is LAN3. For B6, incoming is LAN3, outgoing is LAN3. This is path 1. In another path, for B4, incoming is LAN2, outgoing is LAN4. So using the single root, the broadcast frame, now the source has sent an all that, the route casting, the broadcast root frame to all the destinations. But now as per our problem, we want to establish connections between S1 to S3. So now you know S2, it is not a destination. So S2 discard all the informations. It discard all the informations. Only S3 will receive all the informations. Then you know it will remove all the respective the root. It will resend again back to the respective the S1. It will resend to the S1. So the next one, the first one is nothing but the single route we have completed. Next, all routes. So now from S3, it go back to S1 with all the possible routes. So all the possible routes. It will start from LAN 5. Either it will go through B6 or through B7. So if you see then these things, from LAN 5, it goes to B6. This is the path 1. This is path 1. This is path 2. So it will go to B6. Path 1, path 2. From B6, it will go to LAN 3. So B6 to LAN 3. From LAN 3, it contains three routes. B2, B3, B5. So B2, B3, B5. B2, B3, B5. So now B2 will send to LAN 1. So we have seen that predetermined criteria. It chooses path on some predetermined criteria. So what is the predetermined criteria? So during each and every time bridge before passing to the LAN, it will look back to the respective route, whether that LAN is presented in the backward directions or not. That means if the particular LAN is repeating, automatically it will discard, it won't forward. That is nothing but the predetermined, because already
that LAN, it is there in the routing table. If it is in the routing table, it won't transmit. For example, from B2 to LAN 1. If you see here in the look back, LAN 1 is not in a route. So it forward the routing frame to LAN 1. Similarly, B3 to LAN 2, again it look backs before transmitting. So if you see here, there is no LAN 2 in a look back route, so it transmits. Similarly, the B5, it transmit to LAN 4. Before that, it look back to all. There is no LAN 4 in a previous look back at the conditions, so it transmits. Now, the respective frame is at LAN 1, at LAN 2, at LAN 4. Now, the different possibilities. Because from B2, it comes to LAN 1. So, it contains, LAN 1 contains only B1 as the output bridge. So, now it moves to B1. So, now it moves to B1. For LAN 2, it contains two outputs. One is B1, another is B4. So, from LAN 2, it is moving to B1, B4. For LAN 4, it contains two outputs, B4, B7. So, B4, B7. Okay. Now, this one route is at the B1. Now, B1 is forwarding the frame here. Before forwarding to LAN 2, it look back, it checks whether LAN 2, it is there in the look back path. No, it is not there. So, it forward to LAN 2. So, B1 in these directions, B1, it will transmit to LAN 1. So, in this path, it before transmitting, it look back whether it is there or not. So, LAN 1 is not there, it is transmitting. So, B4 in this path, it is transmitting LAN 4. Before transmitting, it looks whether LAN 4 is existing or not. So, it is not existing, it is transmitting. Now, the frame at LAN 4, either it will, bridge 4, either it will go in this directions. So, it is checking, no, there is no here. So, now B7 will transmit to LAN 5. Before transmitting LAN 5, B7, it look back the routing, whether the ID is available, LAN 4, LAN 3, LAN 5. So, LAN 5 is available. So, B7, it discard the frame. It won't send, it discard the frame. This is the predetermined criteria. If the respective LAN ID is present in a look back the path, then automatically that frames will be discarded because this will use to avoid the looping. Again, if I am selecting LAN 5, again it go back to B6. Suppose, for example, from B7, if I am selecting LAN 5, again it go to B6, again you know looping will be happening. To avoid looping, during that inverse process, it checks each and every LAN, that is, you know, the look back, the protocol, the routing informations. If it is, the LAN is existing in the existing the routing, it will discard. So this frame has been discarded. So it has been discarded. Similarly, another from LAN 2, so in these directions, it will go to B4, B3. From LAN 1, it will go to B2. This path will go to B2. From LAN 4, so similarly, you know, this path will go to either LAN B5, LAN B7. So, LAN 2, B3. The next is nothing but LAN 3. It look backs the respective path. LAN 3 is existing. So, now it is discarded. It is discarded. It won't transmit. So, from B4 to LAN 4, before that it checks look back. There is no LAN 4, so it is transmitted. So, another path, LAN 1 to B2, it will go to B2 to LAN 3. before transmitting, it look backs the path. Yeah, LAN 3 is existing. It is discarding. It will discard. Similarly, LAN 4 to B5, the next one, LAN 4 to B5, it will send to LAN 3. It checks LAN 3 is existing. It will discard. Similarly, LAN 4 B7, again, it will send to LAN 5. LAN 5 is existing. Look back. It will discard. Similarly, then last conditions, this also will be discarded. Now the S3, it responds to S1 through this bridge, through one path, it respond to the S1. Similar way, you should respond to another path, that is B7. Similar way, you should respond to another path. The similar way, we are repeating with the similar way. So we are repeating with the similar way. So B7 to LAN 4. So LAN 4 to B4, B5. LAN 4 to B4, B5. Now B4 will transmit to LAN 2. Before that, it will look back the routing. There is no LAN 2. Now it is coming to LAN 2. Now it is coming to LAN 2. Similarly, B5 will send to LAN 3. It look back the routing. There is no LAN 3 here. So now it forward the frame to LAN 3. So now the frame is at LAN 2, LAN 3. So from LAN 2, it will go either to B1 or B3. So B1, B3. From LAN 3, it will go to either B2 or B3. So B2, B3, and B6. Okay. Now, all the frames will be at B1, B3, B2, B6. So next one. So from B1, it will go to LAN 1. Before transmitting the frame, it will look back the routing. There is no LAN 1 in the path. It sent to LAN 1. Now it sent to LAN. Similarly, LAN 2 to B3, LAN 2 to B3. Now it will send to LAN 3. Before that, it is checking LAN 3 is there. No. Now it sends to LAN 3. Then B2 to LAN 1. B2 to LAN 1. Before that, it checks. No LAN 1 in the path. It sends. No LAN 1 in the path. Then LAN 3, B3. LAN 3, B3. Next is it go to LAN 2. So LAN 2, there is no in the path. It selects. Now if you see B6, LAN 3, B6, it will send to LAN 5. But before transmitting, it look back the routing. Yeah, LAN 5 is present here. That means if it sent to LAN 5, it will create the looping. It will discard the routing frame. It will discard the routing. So similarly, it repeats all. It repeats all. So LAN 1, B2, the same similar way, it repeats all until otherwise all the bridge discards the frames. Discards the frames. Now we have found the many way from S3 to S1. We have found many way from S3 to S1. Now the given question is, after these things you have to find the different path between S3, S1. Different path between S3, S1. So this is nothing but done respective the the broadcast routing frame from S3 to S1. Now we have to find the various route between S1 to S3. Now S1 is connected at LAN 1. So now I will mark the route from LAN 1, because S1 is connected to LAN 1. S3 is at LAN 5, because in the given problem, it is given as, suppose S1 wants to send a frame to S3.
So what are different route? Now we can update. We can update different route. The first route from LAN 1 V to LAN 3. This is the one. This is the another route. This is the third route. This is the fourth route. This is the fourth possible route. This is the fifth possible route. This is the sixth possible route. This is the seventh possible route. So from S1 to S3, we are having totally 7 possible routes. So all these informations will be updated at the LAN 1 S1. Again, if in the future, if again S1 wants to send the information to S3, so now S1 will select any one route from these things depending upon the conditions, depending upon the cost. It will select one route to send an information from S1 to S3. We see here, in a transparent bridge using spanning tree, all those complexity has been involved with the bridge. Here, all the complexity has been involved only with respect to the source node, that is a node. So this is an alternate method to avoid complexity in the routing. But if you see one more of the basic difference, in a transparent bridge, there is no physical connection. It is a connectionless, because the block codes will block, then remaining it will be connected. Here, but in a source routing bridge, it contains 7 physical connections between S1 to S3. 7 the possible physical connections between S1 to S3. So it is a connection oriented. So transparent, it is a connectionless. It is a connection oriented. Then complexity, there it involves only on that with respect to bridge. Here complexity is involved with all the nodes. So these are all the basic difference between the respective the transparent bridge with the source routing. So in the module 2, we have seen about the devices which is used to establish the LAN, that means the hub, repeaters, bridge, switch, router, all these things we have seen. Then we have seen the different types of bridge. Then how the routing information will be updated, we have seen that. Then we have seen about transparent bridge, looping problem in transparent bridge. To overcome that, we have seen with the spanning tree to block unwanted ports. Then the drawbacks or bottleneck of the transparent bridge, all the complexity it involved only on the bridge. So to overcome that, then we move to the SRB, the source routing bridge. Source routing bridge, here you know all the complexity will be shared by all the stations, not only on the bridge, only on the. That's all about the module 2. So coming Friday during our regular class, you may have the quiz 1. So it will be on the Moodle platform. So the portion for that, it is a module 1, module 2. So kindly prepare well. So during this Friday class, so we will have 10 minutes online quiz. After that, we will continue the class.
I'm sorry, sir. There's a DA submission for Friday. So can you please upload the question?
Immediately I will upload.
And sir, can you repeat the portion for the quiz? Module 1.
Module 1, module 2.
Okay, sir.
Okay.
So,
sorry, when is the quiz?
Friday. Friday, regular class.
Friday, regular class. Okay.
Yeah. Also, I will post in a WhatsApp message regarding this, you can kindly refer beta packets.
The portion module 1.
Module 1, module 2.
Okay, sir.
Okay, thank you. Okay, but thank you. So you can leave. Thank you. Take care. Bye.
What about the DA question?
DA, now I will upload. After the class, I will upload the questions. You can complete and upload in a beta. So one question already last.